So today I'm with Erik van Asselt, CEO of CNC.
Welcome at our company.
Thank you. How would you describe what CNC is?
Well, CNC is at the moment the biggest substrate producer in Europe. We are the only substrate producer that produces substrate for agaricus, champignons, and for exotic mushrooms. We have facilities in two countries at the moment. We have three factories in Netherlands and one in Poland.
Can you tell me some numbers about your production? How much substrate do you produce in a week?
At the moment, we produce about 9 to 9.5 thousand tons per week.
It's phase three compost.
Phase three compost, including 200 to 300 tons of exotic mushrooms substrate.
And I read that you supply not only locally, but in many countries around the world.
At this moment, we deliver our substrate approximately in 40 countries in the world. In bulk, we deliver almost throughout complete Europe. In packages of 20 kilos agaricus, we can ship all over the world. And we recently started to export the exotics blocks also to Israel, to South Africa, to the United States.
3 years ago, CNC went through big changes in the ownership structure, and you CNC stopped being cooperative, mm-hmm. And start to be commercial company.
Commercial company in the usual this market meaning. Focus.
First question is what cooperative members got from this deal?
Well, the cooperative members sold the company, so they sold their shares to Sun Capital.
Yeah, so all of cooperative members and the number of cooperative members was around 100, mm-hmm. I guess, got just money and sold the business.
They got money and sold the business. That's true.
And now the objective, as I can guess, objective of Sun European Partners is to make company value bigger and sell it. After a while,
we will be sold again sometime. There is not a certain period for Sun, and always when a private equity comes on board of a company, they will make it bigger, better, more profitable, and in the end, we will be sold again. And what we thought was very important that we keep the name CNC. Because CNC is already 70 years old, and CNC used to stand for Cooperative Nederlands Champignontelersvereniging, yeah, Cooperative Dutch Growers Association, and we renamed the company. Yeah, we kept the letters CNC, and now the company name is Circular Natural Compost.
Oh, really? I didn't know this. In which way your new owner going to increase the value of company, and what changes you're going to implement in the future to increase this?
Well, we implemented a system into the company. It's called Fit for Future. And with Fit for Future, we have several projects each year on every department, what makes us better. Every time we walk through the company, we think, what can be better? What can go cheaper? What will lead to a better quality? What will lead to a better customer satisfaction? So every focus is on improving the company, improving the products on every level.
Can you tell me some examples of this process?
Well, we focus always on the quality of the substrate. And we look at the quality of our raw materials. And we always think, what would the grower think of this when we make changes? And we also ask growers. And the input that we have from our quality and sales department, we put in our goals for the near future again.
Your company, for a long time, benefits from quite cheap raw material, horse manure. I guess you get it almost for free from...
Well, we have a very expensive logistic department from AMCO. We run with 30 own trucks. So yeah, when you look at the benefits that we have in the Benelux versus the rest of Europe, yeah, we have a little advantage on the raw materials, but other costs in Netherlands are more expensive than, for example, in Poland. So yeah, there will be a little shift of raw materials versus other costs, and in the end, it will be almost equal.
And now prices for compost in Netherlands are quite the same as in Poland. Is this correct?
It's still a little bit cheaper. Poland is still more expensive than Netherlands. So we still have the advantage of the raw materials, but other costs like labor or like fuel or that kind of cost, yeah, they increased a lot in the past few years.
Do you produce organic mushroom compost and what is share of organic mushroom compost?
At this moment we produce at our company exotic mushrooms 100% organic, and for the agaricus we have this special exclusive cooperation with the company Hereco, where we produce the phase one compost exclusively for Hereco, and they produce the phase three out of the raw materials that we provide. And at the moment we produce about between 1,000 and 1,500 tons phase one per week.
Let's talk a little bit about Dutch mushroom industry. In Netherlands there were more than 700 growers 30 years ago, around 420 years ago, now 60, 70
in average. Yeah.
67. How do on your point, from your point of view, this number will change over the years?
I think the number of organizations will decrease slowly, but I think the square meters of farms, they will be stable. The farms will be a little bigger. What is very important is the new developments on picking costs. In the past it was like the Benelux had the benefits of the raw materials. Poland had the benefits of lower picking costs, but due to the automatization in the picking part of the company, in the near future, then the picking costs will be a little less important than in the past. So the competition between Poland and Netherlands will be beneficial for the Dutch growers.
Am I correct when I think that when robots finally come to the picking mushrooms, industry again can shift a little bit to, in direction of Netherlands?
Yeah, exactly.
Do you have enough raw materials to increase production of compost and supply enough compost for this growth?
One, yes, we have enough raw materials because there are enough stables in the area of Netherlands, Belgium and Germany. We still have the capability of scale up, but at our factory in Moerdijk we also have the possibility to use straw. So we are very flexible and not only using horse manure. But there is another trend also going on, and that is more local for local production. What you see in Germany, what you see in France, what you see in Switzerland is, and also other countries, that they like the locally grown mushrooms. So that is a good development for the countries like Germany and France, but it's less a good direction for the countries that are exporting. But out of substrate perspective, yeah, it's a way of organizing the logistics in a different way, because now we don't have to bring the substrate anymore to a grower that is exporting the mushrooms. No, now we are exporting the substrate.
Yeah, so you actually supply not only Netherlands, but all neighboring countries.
Yeah. So in our bulk system, we can drive up to 24 hours if we cool down the compost at our factories.
Diversification or specialization?
No, and in the end, we will look for more product market combinations. From origin, CNC was an organization from and for mushroom growers in the Netherlands. Yeah, and I think when something happens, when you're only having one product market combination, you're vulnerable for what is happening. So we will look for more diverse activities, more countries, more products, looking for markets that are maybe anti-cycles towards our own market. So if something happens in one market, we can focus on another market. Out of the perspective of the cooperative, it was good how it was in that situation, but now that we are a standalone substrate company and the growers that were in the cooperative and now our clients, and we live in a free country, they are not obliged to buy with us, we have to have another policy in the company. That we now also cooperating with companies that produce other products out of mycelium. Not only edible mushrooms, but there will also be developments of producing leather out of mycelium. There are even coffins at the moment produced out of mycelium. There are all different types of other uses of mycelium into the medical industry instead of only producing for the consumption of mushrooms.
Have you already studied possibilities on in producing this mycelium materials, or I know
yes.
you're already in the process of trials or so, something like this. Can you say more about this?
We work with partners together who are already have advanced technologies in those directions, and we work together with them in developments.
So the idea is to produce mycelium materials by CNC or to sell substrate for mycelium material producers?
At this moment, we stick to the part of we produce the raw materials, so the substrate, and other partners, they can build other things with it.
CNC has exotic part of the business for 20 years already.
Mm-hmm.
How important this part is? You're building new facility, but still the share of this business is big, but not crucial. How do you see development of exotic business?
Yeah, when you see the developments in the world, then we look a bit to Asia. Yeah, there are over 1,000 species of edible mushrooms, and we in our company only produce 8. So I think in the near future, the development of the exotic mushroom will be huge. And now we do in our company, I think 10% of our revenue is exotics, but that will grow. So the growth of exotic mushrooms will be increased when you compare it to the agaricus. And the agaricus will be the same, and we will ship it to different areas of Europe.
How do you see mushroom business here in the country now?
Well, if you look at the Dutch developments, you saw that the price of the mushrooms was always below €1 for a consumer package. In the past 2 years, it increased 50 to 60%. But what you also see is that this 50 to 60% is not equally divided among the parties. So if you compare that to how much money there is available in the value chain out of the consumer perspective, then you talk about 500-700 euros per ton of substrate. But the grower has not an increased margin. The substrate producers have not an increased margin. So that means that most of the money is still at the wholesaler or the retailer. So they make a lot of money out of the mushrooms, but the producers see the grower and the producer of the raw materials did not have any of the increase of the money.
What is the most important things for compost producers?
For us, it's very important that we every day think about quality. Quality, quality, quality. When CNC was sold 4 years ago, we had this slogan and we said quality first. And that's what we do. We always think about quality. Our goal is to be a quality leader on every product that we produce.
What yield your clients expect from compost they buy from you?
It depends a little bit of how they grow. Is it a grower that has his own retailer, then he picks whenever the client needs the mushrooms. Is it a grower who sells to the wholesaler, then he tries to have the maximum out of his kilos. And I think sometimes people say, I have 29 or I have 30 kilos per square meter, but it also depends on how many kilos of substrate did you put on a square meter. Better way to measure it is how many euros did I earn per ton of compost. Normally 29 kilos per square meter is a very fair yield.
And this is from two breaks?
From two breaks, yeah. Two breaks.
How, what percentage of growers collect mushrooms manually and mechanically? As I understand, canning business a little bit going down here by
year? They suffer, at this moment they suffer from the export markets. Within the portfolio of CNC, I think it's about 70% is hand picking and 30% is industrial.
Tell me about future of CNC. How you see the company in 10 years?
In 10 years, I think we will be bigger. We will have more facilities out of Europe. Our exotics part will be more dominant within the portfolio of CNC. We have a lot more knowledge of mushrooms and exotics than we have now. I hope in 10 years, so that's over 3,600 days, that we made 3,600 small steps and that it's a marathon instead of a sprint, so that we achieve the goals that we set now to be the best at every product that we produce and can sell it at a fair price to the growers. Well, we export already to a few countries outside of Europe. And now 60 to 70% of our business is Europe and 20% is out. But we will look more and more into the possibilities of exporting into the world. We are in the Silicon Valley of mushroom development. When you come into the world and you visit a grower, then they talk about the Dutch way of the Dutch system of mushroom growing. And that has a reason, because it was all born in the Netherlands.
This year you celebrate 70 years of CNC. What comes to your mind when you think about this?
Well, I'm 5 years on board of CNC. Normally in Netherlands you get your pension when you are 68, but we are 70 and we feel young, we feel energetic, we feel like we are ready for the future. So we don't feel this old age.
wish you great success and achievement of your goals in the nearest future.
Hey, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.